Christ was God's son through the scriptures. I'll just close the door here because the dear lady was getting a little cold here. And the Bible says that he convinced people that Jesus was the Messiah through the scriptures. Now let me remind you, in those days there was no New Testament. How did they find Jesus without the New Testament? How did Paul the Apostle discover him without the New Testament? Because Jesus is revealed in this book. We don't need the New Testament. All we need is a divine, God-given hunger to seek him. And we'll find him. They found him without Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, without the book of Acts and the epistles, because of their hunger. They had a revelation of him. Now, we're about to partake communion, and I want Kurt to please come, and maybe Larry can help him, and pass the communion elements to the precious people here. And I want you to get ready yourself to partake communion with us. But let's make a commitment. Go ahead and pass it out. Let's make a commitment today. We are going to seek the Lord with all our hearts in 2011. 2011 will be our year from heaven if we seek the Lord with all our hearts. He who stilled the storm, he that cleansed lepers, he that healed the sick and raised the dead, in whose name we can receive life, liberty, and peace. When we say in Jesus' name, we bring him on the scene. Only if we walk with him. You can say in Jesus' name all you want. Nothing will happen if you're not walking with him. But if you are walking with him, then his name will bring him on the scene. Oh, how I wish we had more time together. But because of the rain, we're limited. And we're limited even to what we're doing now. Because of circumstances, I'm only able to come to you for about 40 minutes. And in the next few moments, we are going to partake communion together. Just at midnight. And I pray the presence of God will become so real and tangible in your life. Now, as they still pass the communion, as you prepare your communion, please let me just say a few more things to you. Precious saints, I've been serving the Lord now 36 years. I was born in this land. Today I went and saw the spot where the Lord appeared to me when I was just 11 years old, in our home in Jaffa. I went there today. And as I was standing there, the reality of that moment came back. I looked through the window of that bedroom that was locked up and dark in there. And all I could think about is, when I was just a little boy, the Son of God appeared to me. And here, years later, I'm 58 years old now, years later, I'm amazed by what he has done. But I've learned one thing about him. He's the same yesterday, today, forever. He never changes. He's ever merciful, ever gracious, long-suffering, and loving. It's amazing he puts up with us. It's amazing he has not cut us off. It's amazing he has not forsaken us. I've said to him many times, I said, you can punish me all you want, just never leave me. Never walk away. Lord, you can punish me all you want. You can rebuke me all you want, just don't leave. How many feel the same? Put your hands way up high. Because our love for him is deep. Our love is very deep for him. Where would we be without him? Where would you be without him? So what am I talking to you about today? I'm talking about one thing. The Son of God. Just seek him. Get to know him. Get to walk with him. Realize his nature is a hiding nature. He'll hide from you purposely, that you might seek him and go after him. And when you do, do it with all your heart. In prayer, Wait upon the Lord. Don't just rush in and rush out. Don't just pray just because you're so full of pain and burdens. Just wait on Him. Play some lovely music. Can I have my iPad from there? Let me just as we come to this moment, I want to show you what I do. I want to show you what I did this morning. I put my iPad on and I played this. Fairest Lord Jesus. And you can't hear it probably too well, but maybe you can over there. And I just sat there in my bed. And next thing I know, I'm crying. And I spent probably an hour and a half this morning. And I just looked at the city of Jerusalem. It was 7 this morning. And I began just weeping. I didn't say anything to Him. Sometimes it's best to just be quiet. And let the Lord talk to you. I think the apostles would have loved to have something like this. Or Paul. And you just sit there. Or you lay in your bed, or you get on your knees, and you just listen. And you think about Him. Isn't this lovely? And your heart just melts. And now you start to think about what she's singing, that most beautiful hymn. Fairest Lord Jesus, and your burdens just vanish. Why don't you just lift your hands and love Him? Jesus is fairer. Jesus is purer. Makes a sorrowing heart. He gives that heart joy and peace. Beautiful Savior, Lord of the nations. Why don't you just call on His name right now? Son of God. And Son of Man. Glory and honor to You. Praise and adoration. Now and forevermore be Thine. We have a few minutes. And this is our cry. Listen to this. I don't know how long we have. Would someone tell me? Listen to this. This is one of the most precious hymns. I need thee every hour. Lift up that bread, will you? Say, dear Jesus, I love you, Lord. And I need you, Lord. But with all my heart, forgive my sin, Lord. Don't hold them against me. I come back to the cross to receive forgiveness and cleansing and purity. And I partake this bread dependent on your mercy. Touch my life again. Let 2011 be my year from heaven. In your precious name. I remember, Lord, when they whipped you and beat you and mocked you and spit on you and crucified you. I should have been punished. I should have been crucified. But you took it. You took my place. With all my heart, I thank you. I give you my life afresh. Take it now, Lord. Amen. Partake the bread in Jesus' name. Just lift your hands and love him. And tell him how much you love him. Take this moment, we have just a few minutes. Ask him to cleanse your life. Wash that sin away. Wash that iniquity away. For it says, bless the Lord, O my soul, who forgiveth all thine iniquities. He heals all thy diseases. And he redeems your life from destruction. And crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies. He has not dealt with us after our sins. Nor does he reward us according to our iniquities. No, his mercy is great, saints. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgressions from us. Lift that cup. Say, dear Jesus, I thank you for your blood. Wash me now. Cleanse me now. I give you my life. I give you my all. Purify me, Lord. Making me whiter than snow. Do not look upon my sin. For it is great. But your mercy is greater. Your grace is greater. And I remember when you shed your blood for me. For me, you shed it for me. I partake now in your precious name. Amen. There is therefore now no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus. As we enter the new year, let's lift our hands and thank him. And let's tell him we will seek him with all our heart, with all our being, with all our strength. We will not turn back. Say, dear Jesus, Give me your strength.
Give me your power.
To find you. As I seek you. I will find you. Amen. Let me pray for you. Precious Jesus, I pray right now that your mighty power will descend. Stretch your hands towards this camera. That 2011 will be the year where everyone will know you in depth. In Jesus' mighty name. May the power of the Holy Spirit rest upon every life. Amen, amen, and amen. I'm here to tell you that 2011 will be your greatest year ever. I'm here to tell you that God Almighty is going to establish you in Jesus' name. Now take your prayer requests up and let's pray for the people. Believe God that 2011 is your year from heaven. How much time do we have, gentlemen?
30 seconds.
If this was live, we would have had more time. But we've done the best we could because of the rain out there. But these precious saints who are here, come from around the world, this was a hastily put together group, are going to be praying for you now. Know and believe. Father, we agree in Jesus' name. Lay your hands on these prayer requests. That every need will be met. Every prayer will be answered. Every cry heard. For your glorious and awesome name's sake. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.